It's pathetic. Make some friends.
Do you still need a bed for tonight?
Hey. You know the rules on visitors.
You reckon you could get this bloke Sheldon to do anything for you, then?
Of course I could.
I bet you can't get him to wipe your arse.
You got me to wipe your arse, Paul. Your arse for a bet.
I won.
I'll strangle you!
You don't wish to press charges?
Nope.
Against a naked tramp who's trying to strangle you in your own home?
He's a mate. I'd love it if you stayed.
Yeah, well, perhaps. But just one night.
Great.
Bloody hell, Paul.
Your turn to do breakfast.
What do you mean, my turn?
I've drawn up a rotor to prevent arguments, and I've moved my stuff to the top shelf of the fridge.
Paul, I've stayed here one night. We're not flatmates.
There's only one rule. No selling your big issues on the premises.
I don't sell the big issue.
And if you use a plate, wash it up afterwards. Don't just lick it and put it back.
What is this? Play Misty for me? Huh? I don't live here. I'm going.
Going where? You're homeless. It's miserable out there.
Miserable? I think you'll find it's more miserable in here. I've only known you one day. You've had me shoplift, you got me arrested, you made me wipe your... Goodbye.
All right. I'll make breakfast. You do it tomorrow.
There won't be a tomorrow.
I know I've been a bit mean to you.
A bit?
I'm all right when you get to know me.
Paul, our relationship has gone as far as I want to take it.
Overnight, so that makes us quits.
Fine, quits. Goodbye.
Oi, you! Get out now, go on.
Don't worry, love, I'm going.
Oh, don't you threaten me. I'll call the police.
Can you open this for me, please?
Oh, so that's what you want me to do, is it?
Yeah.
Sheldon, don't go.
Oh, Paul, love, are you all right? Did he hurt you?
No, he's my friend.
Don't be a fool, he's no friend of yours.
She's right, you know, I'm not.
You are. He is, and here you are kicking a helpless, pathetic man, a man who has nothing out onto the streets.
Paul, I'm not running a hostel. I can't just take in anyone.
If that man leaves here, he'll be dead by tomorrow.
Well, that's not our problem.
Jean, I thought you cared about people. There's a helpless man reaching out to us here.
Help! Somebody! Help!
It's your chance to go the extra mile. When he's back on his feet, he'll look back and say, it's Jean who made the difference. Jean Carter, the Warden of Hope.
Warden of Hope.
Hello?
Oh, for goodness sake. Oh, you!
What?
Come here. If you're that desperate to stay, then come with me. I'll see what I can do.
Oh, I don't want to stay. I want you to kick me out. You can't trust me. I've got nits.
That's it, Sheldon. I'll put the kettle on.
You're on. Count me in.
So remember, mum's the word. Cash only. 4 o'clock refreshments provided.
What's it for, Sid? You having a party?
Countdown.
Countdown's 3:30. You're playing poker.
We're not.
Is it going to come?
No, close friends only.
Close friends, nothing. You're inviting people who are crap.
Charming.
All right, so you got me. You're not invited because it's gormless idiots only. Speaking of which, where's Paul?
So that's settled. He'll stay here and live with me.
I think we can discuss that without your help. Thank you, Paul. Now bugger off.
I'm sorry, Sheldon, but we just can't accommodate non-disabled residents here.
I don't want accommodating. I want releasing. There's laws against kidnapping, you know.
But there is something I can do.
What are you going to do? Chop my legs off? Like on that film, Misery.
She didn't chop his legs off, Sheldon. She shattered his ankles with a lump hammer. We don't shatter people's ankles with lump hammers here.
No.
What we do is we offer hope. Excuse me. Thank you, Paul. I think I know of a way to help you get back into society.
Yes, so do I. Open the gate and let me out.
No, I meant I might be able to find you a job.
That's very kind of you, but if you don't open the gate in a minute, I'm going to go and find Paul and use his head as a battering ram. Did you get that, Paul?
He's only joking.
I can't offer you very much money. Say, £50?
To do what?
Oh, just a few odd jobs here and there. Just for today.
Hang on. Why are you being so nice all of a sudden? 5 minutes ago, you wouldn't get the police.
I try to look for the good in people, Sheldon. Just think of me as the Warden of Hope.
What?
Warden of Hope is... it's just a silly nickname. You don't have to. It's,
no, fine. Warden of Hope it is. Now, where do I start?
We'll use Graham's flat, because Jean won't suspect it.
Lovely. Of course. I'll have to put an IOU in.
Yeah, well, bollocks to that, Paul. It's cash or nothing. What about your boyfriend? Would he be up for it?
He hasn't got any money, have you, Sheldon? He's a tramp.
So was Charlie Chaplin.
I knew it. They're all loaded, these homeless. It was in the Daily Mail.
Get lost. This was off her. The Warden of Hope.
Warden of Hope? That was my line. She gave you that money because of me, so half of it's mine.
Get lost. I've earned this.
In 2 minutes. What are you doing there?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Poker show.
Might have.
You keep him out of that card game.
What are you, his mum?
Think about it. He plays poker, but he's on the streets. What does that tell you?
Tells me he's crap at it.
It tells you he's got a problem. He's a gambling addict and you're trying to take advantage.
Fine, I'll move on. Plenty of other suckers around.
Sheldon.
Hello, Moss Lane Police Station.
Hello, it's Jean at Ramble Lodge.
Jean, what can I do for you?
I've got a fellow here in need of a job.
Well, I'm all in favour of inclusion, Jean, but you can't chase a mugger if somebody's got to push a wheelchair.
No, he doesn't use a wheelchair.
You can't
hunt down a joyrider in one of those adapted cars. You know, the big, tall ones with it. They still have them.
Sergeant.
I mean, the fact is, Jean...
Policing is a very, very physical job.
It's not for a resident. It's for a friend of the lodge. You know him, actually. It's, Sheldon.
That bog-eyed tramp? It's only 12 hours since I arrested him.
Look, he's not still...
There, is he, Jean? Kick him out. He's a psycho.
He's no more a psycho than you or I.
Now, I think that between us, we could make somewhat of them special constables.
Him? A special?
If anyone can provide a role model for him, Sergeant, it's you.
Yeah, well, yeah.
I know you're a very busy man and you can't just be here in 5 minutes.
That's right, yeah. Make it 10. Take over the desk, Sarah. I'm just nipping down Bramble Lodge.
Again? You're there a lot these days.
Well, she's an important part of the community.
She?
It's them, the wheelchair people. They're members of society too.
Well, what are you going down for?
Oh, they picked up some tramp. Reckons he can be a police officer. Hobo cop. I'll soon knock that out of him.
She didn't quite shine to me, that Jean.
You reckon?
Hmm. And it must make a nice change for her, having someone around who's, you know.
A tramp?
Can you not use the word tramp, please?
All right. Junkie, loser, smackhead.
Hey! How would you like it if I called you a load of offensive names?
Like what? Go on.
Wheelman?
Wheelman?
Lazy legs. Chair face. Wheelchair face.
Very hurtful. Look, we got off to a bad start, me and you. Why don't we give it another go?
You're not wiping your arse again.
Let's forget about my arse.
What? Put it behind us.
wipe the slate clean.
Yeah, perhaps with a nice, friendly game of cards.
I'll see you, Paul.
Three nines.
Full house.
Tits.
Oh, I'm so glad you talked me into this. Beats begging. You know, I really feel like I've earned this.
I'll win it back, don't worry.
Nah, we'll leave it at that, you're all right.
What?
I'll just cash these in, please.
You can't stop, you're a gambling addict.
No, I'm not. Right, that's, £42 exactly.
It's dishonest what you just did.
Eh?
You tricked me into thinking you had a gambling problem and lured me into your little game.
Hang on, what if I did have a gambling problem? You'd have just set me back 10 years.
And now you're taking money off a disabled person. That's my benefit, Sheldon. Need that money for food.
Come on, £42.
I'm skint. Couldn't sort out a loan, could you?
No, I could not sort out a loan. You're the one with the gambling problem.
Perhaps I'll just have to take payment in kind.
Get off!
Oh, the DVD player.
What about it?
Is it multi-region?
Put it back!
Oh, you get a tenner for this.
Ah, I'll take the stereo as well.
Thought we might find them in here. Building up quite a friendship, these two.
Burglary now, is it?
No, no, Paul's the villain here, not me.
What are you doing with them, then?
I was just fixing them.
Oh, aye, yeah. Looks like it. You could do 20 years for this.
He was only messing.
20 years. In the police force.
What's he talking about?
I said I'd get you a job, Sheldon. And I have. As a special constable.
If I think you've got what it takes.
You're taking a piss.
Oh, come on, Sheldon.
A copper working for him. I'd rather starve.
Told you he's not up for it, Jean. The only special he cares about comes in cans.
Well, I'm disappointed, Sheldon, but if you insist on leaving, then just give me back my money and be on your way.
Fine, I will. Oh, actually, I'll give you £8. He can owe you the 42. I just won it off him.
One? We don't gamble here, do we, Jean?
Not at Bramble Lodge, we don't, no. So, what's it to be?
Give me the jacket.
Oh, very nice. It suits you, Sheldon. Very handsome.
Right, come on then.
Brush up quite well, don't you?
Ooh, think.
Right, come on now.
You go for it, mate. Very handsome.
Get that filled in, assuming you can write.
Got a pen?
Oh, yeah. Here you go.
You are far too trusting, Jean. That's the real reason I'm here, in case he turns nasty.
I only lent him a biro.
You need to be careful. You're a good-looking, a good woman. I mean, you look after all these people, but who looks after you? You need...
Done it.
Right. Read it back then, yeah?
Oh. Name, Sheldon. Address, none. Why do you wish to become a special constable? Don't know. When do I start?
Not yet, my friend. You've got the training programme to get through first.
What do you mean, training?
First thing to do is clear up some misconceptions about police work. It's not all cops and robbers stuff. Most of your time will be spent building relationships within the community.
What was that for?
Test your reflexes. Trained officer would have seen that coming.
Oh, you didn't see that one, did you?
Not a wise move, Sheldon.
If I have to come over there, you'll feel the back of my hand.
I should warn you that before I joined the police force, I spent 2 years in the armed forces, so I don't mess about.
Oh, did you? Yeah, so did I. But I was in there for 5, so technically I outrank you. So on your knees, polish my boots.
You're not in the army now, Sheldon?
No.
No what?
No, sir.
No, sir, what, sir?
No, sir, I'm not in the army, sir, but, sir, with respect, sir, neither are you, sir.
That's right. Right, one. Now, drop on the ground and give me 20. Now!
So, just the three of us, then.
Yep.
Yeah. 4.
You can't play, Graham. There's nobody to hold your cards.
Oh, that's it.
Yes, there is.
Oh, no, no. You're barred.
I'm not playing. I'm just holding Graham's cards.
putting his money in for him, Anna.
That's right.
Sit down.
Deal me in.
Spare change, forgot I had it.
Very flash.
Hey! Hey, so come on, when do I get me truncheon?
Truncheon?
Yeah, truncheon.
Truncheon.
That's what I said, truncheon.
Anyway, it's a baton. And not until I think you're ready.
Come on, give me one.
Huh? Feel the end of mine in a minute.
See you, dog.
Oh.
Oh. Glad to see you two getting on better.
Yeah, he said I could feel the end of his truncheon.
I never said truncheon.
Well, as long as you're making friends.
Oh, yes, Jean. Lots in common. Both been in the army.
Really?
Yeah. A lot of these homeless types are ex-soldiers, Jean. Some of us can handle life on Civvy Street, some of us can't.
Oh. I didn't know you were a soldier.
Yeah, that was in the past. I don't really like to talk about that stuff.
I understand. Why? What happened?
I'm more interested in you, Jean. Are you married?
No.
Engaged?
No.
Boyfriend?
No.
Girlfriend?
That's enough of that!
Yeah, you're not interested in me.
Oh, he is. Look, you can tell.
Right, that's it. Tea break's over. Come on. I want to see you on the grass. I want forward rolls. Come on.
What you got?
Two pair. Aces, sevens.
Tits.
Thank you, gentlemen.
It's a bit of a coincidence, isn't it, Graham? Never played before in your life, but as soon as she's holding your cards, you're a hustler.
It's my poker face.
Poker ass. She's helping you.
Just checking in, Graham. Everything all right?
I'm fine.
All right, love. I'll leave you to it.
Graham's taking a big risk letting you play here. Think about that before you go making accusations. Ramble Lodge, Jean Carter speaking.
Jean, it's
PC Madden. Can you tell him to switch his radio back on, please? He's not taking any calls.
That's because he's training.
Jean, please.
He's got no intention of making that guy special.
Of course he has. Why else would he be here?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
Because he likes showing off in front of you.
Jean, come and see. I've got him standing on one leg touching his nose.
Are you serious about training Sheldon as a special constable?
Of course I am. We need specials to help supplement the work of proper officers.
Make the police more representative of the local
community.
Thank you. See?
And everyone else around here is a bit of a special. Shame for him to be left out, eh?
Tell him to switch his radio back on.
Turn your radio on!
I'm out.
I'll raise you a pound.
Oh. Oh. See your pound.
That's it. She's helping him.
I never said anything.
You looked at him. It's a scam. You're both barred from the game.
I thought yes. There was something fishy.
I'm telling you, as long as it's always...
Just another check, Graham. Everything OK? Graham? Do you want me to pop in on you?
Graham.
Hang on, Graham. I'm coming down.
No.
Hello?
It's OK, Jean. Don't come in. I'm fine.
Are you sure? You sound a bit strange.
I've got a cold.
Fine, Graham. Stay in the game.
Graham, I'm coming down.
It's okay. I'm fine.
If you're sure.
Yes, I'm fine.
Gee, you got any more crunchies in?
Only fun.
I'll take three if you don't mind.
I believe you have some cards to show us.
Queen eye.
Two snowmen. Sorry, gents.
Mm-hmm. I call a tea break.
It's not worth it. You've only got £2 left.
Even so, Sid.
Sid, I need to get my money back. Tell me about it. That one might be a money for a week.
And what if we cheat?
Won't work.
How do you know?
Because I've been doing it for the last half hour, he's made no odds.
There's only one option then. Blow the game. I've got an idea.
It's like watching a tramp version of the Teletubbies, isn't it?
Again!
Oh, it's criminal, this. It's a waste of time. It's like learning bloody aerobics.
He's got a point, Sergeant. I mean, we do all this at Bums and Tums.
Yeah, when are you going to teach me some of the proper stuff? You know, like on the bill.
Such as what?
Well, such as, when is the correct time to say Alpha Bravo Zero? Or how to spot a one-man crime wave? Or...
How to break news of an untimely, gruesome death.
Well, you got to do the paperwork first. Your green sheet, then your blue sheet.
Yeah. He hasn't got a clue, has he? But you don't even watch the bill.
I do.
Yeah, Paul. Ask him a question about the police.
What was on the B side of Roxanne?
Peanuts. Track 5 on Outlandish Tomorrow.
Correct. Shell, can I borrow you for 5 minutes?
Of course you can, little fella. I'm for 10 if you want.
Bring your helmet.
What do you want?
Just thought you'd like a break from the police academy.
Is he coming back or what? Graham's on a winning streak here.
Listen, everyone, I've got something to tell you. Paul's gone to go and get a copper.
Oh, hell.
You know Sheldon, Paul's mate? Well, he's an undercover officer and, well, he's here to investigate claims of illegal gambling.
No, he isn't. He's homeless. I've spared him change.
Yeah, well, he's deep undercover. I tell you what, why don't we all take back his money and we'll forget about it.
Oh, no.
Hello. What's going on here, then?
Quick, get out of here.
Hang on. What's going on here, officer, is that we and Paul are playing poker for money.
I see.
It's not illegal, is it?
I don't know, I wouldn't have thought so.
So none of us are in trouble?
What are you asking me for?
Just curious.
Hey, how come you're playing? I thought you were skint.
He is skint now. He had 50 quid when he came in.
50? You thieving git.
I didn't steal it. It must have fallen out of your coat.
That was my wages, that. I've been dancing around in the garden like Cindy Crawford all afternoon for that money.
Leave me alone. I'll call the police.
I am the police.
Arrest that man.
Aye, I think I will.
What?
Paul. What's your surname?
Ball.
Paul Ball. Paul Ball. Paul Ball. I'm arresting you on the suspicion of theft.
What?
In the army, did you actually, like, kill anyone?
Oh, no. Well, not on purpose, no.
Got one?
Leave me alone. This is harassment.
Ha-ha, look at that. Only been a cop for 10 minutes. I already got my first perp.
Oh, Paul, what have you done?
I've been framed.
So, how does it work? Is it like a bonus or a bounty? Or do you have to convict him first?
Do you mean bonus?
You know, on top of me wages. Is it performance related?
You don't get wages, Sheldon.
What?
You're a special constable. It's voluntary.
I'm supposed to do all this for naught?
You're doing it to serve your community.
Why? It's never served me.
Oh, now, come on. That's hardly the attitude.
Can I go now?
No, you can't. Stay there. Citizen's arrest.
I've spent all day training you for you to throw it back in my face. That's called wasted police time.
Arrest him.
Shut up.
Look, I'm sure that Sheldon would love to take the job.
Chuff, he's not having it. There are certain standards required to be a special constable.
Well, like being a complete knob.
No, like respect for authority and a positive attitude, which you, my friend, ain't got. Now give me the coat and give me the hat.
All units, please respond. Reported robbery on the Washway Estate. Multiple suspects may be armed. Repeat, suspects may be armed. All units proceed at once.
Shouldn't you answer that?
Oh, I didn't catch where it was.
It was on the Washway Estate. Living hell out there.
Yeah, I don't think that's my patch. So, one of the other lads will probably be there now, so.
2 streets away.
Oh, be careful, Sergeant. She said they were armed. They might have swords or big chisels.
Sheldon, do you fancy coming along, bit of training on the job?
Oh, no. Thanks. You sacked me, didn't you? Bad attitude and lack of respect. Hey, Sarge. Don't forget your truncheon.
Well, that could have gone a bit better.
Yeah, sorry, Jean. You did your best.
Well, I thought you'd have made a very good policeman.
Hey, there is some police work I can give you for free. I was in Graham's flat earlier.
Yeah, that's what I was going to tell you, Jean. They're gambling for money. It's nothing to do with me, I swear on my life. I think Graham and Dorothy are behind it.
Oh, are they now? Right.
You're a devious little git, you are.
Only when I have to be. That's what makes me such a good gambler. Know when to bluff, know when to call.
You're a shit gambler.
Yeah. Got into trouble then, though, didn't I?
Hey? In round one, there are 3 minutes on the clock. We'll start with the person who's...
What's going on in here, Graham?
Watching telly.
On your own?
Just me and Anne.
So I see. Correct, Morris. In nature, in that case... Africa, a bush baby is a type of what? Animals... Where did all this money come from?
Bang.
If you'd all like to come out of the bedroom now, please.
I didn't know they were in there.
What am I going to do with you, Graham?
What's going on? Not gambling. We don't gamble here, do we, Jean?
No, we do not. Which is why I am going to take this money and give you all back your fair share.
Hang on!
Yes, Paul.
£50 of that was...
Was what?
Nothing.
You've been warned. By which presenter? Here, that's who, Andrew.
That's Paul. First question, you're 20 pounds. Ah, you daft sod. You're the only one who's lost out.
It was your money.
Oh, yeah, it was, wasn't it?
30 quid each. I'm up.
Bastards. I'm having that money back. I've only known you a day and a half, and already you owe me 92 quid.
I haven't got it.
Before you get a single penny, before you even eat, I'm having that money.
You can't watch me 24 hours a day.
Oh, yes, I can. Every second of every hour, every day.
You can't. Jean said, you're not allowed to stay here.
Oh, look at you two, thick as thieves. I've really noticed a difference in Paul since you've been here, and I've made a decision. I'm going to let you stay.
What?
What?
Oh, don't thank me, Paul.
I'm not.
You really helped me today, telling me about that card game.
I know how unpopular it must have made you. And Sheldon has proved that he can be trusted.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
So, you can do some odd jobs around the place just to pay your way. Here, try this on. It belonged to Bill. He's no longer with us.
Oh.
That's nice, but... I think you'd like to move on.
You're all right, Paul. I'm starting to get used to it around here. Thanks, Jean. I'd love to stay.
Oh, isn't that nice, Paul? Someone to keep an eye on you?
Yeah. Just to keep an eye on you. Every second of every hour of every day.
Oh. I'm perfectly capable of getting a woman by myself.
I've never seen you bring a woman back here.
Of course not. I've got a snoring tramp knocking one out on my couch.
What's that bird in the common room?
Oh, she's a prostitute. I brought her in for Paul.
Get rid of her.
Get on with it.
Oh, she's a prostitute. I brought her in for Paul.
She's just about to go for his mission.
Get rid of her.
She's £1,000 a night.
I'll have the money instead then, please.
I'm with Stupid continues wheeling its way on BBC Three next Sunday at 10:00.